What's up, guys?
It's really early in the morning now, and I'm just getting ready to go over to the Neon. So, start reassembling that for part two. It's just going to be me, because I think everybody else is working. But, you know, I like to help out, so just go solo today. And, look. It's outside. Alright.
Yep, you know what it is.
This is where we left off. The cams need to be put in. Timing needs to be done. The turbo, the intake, everything else is already on. Fuel rail needs to go on, but basically just the timing components. All the cam caps are already labeled, so you know where they go. Cams are back in. Forgot my tripod, so I couldn't really show you me torquing them down, but they're back in. Now we gotta get the gears back on. So, gears in there. Let's go. All right, so the timing belt's back on. It's probably one of the worst timing belts ever to do because you need 19 hands to do it, but it's all back in, all timed up. Marks all line up, so keep moving on. Big bulky engine mount's going in next. It's really a bitch to get in there. Next is a power steering pump. The only way to get at it is like be a full retard, so we'll try that out. So the best way I know how to get at it is actually go under the intake manifold. So you look like a chicken doing it. Down here, somewhere. I don't even know. I'm just gonna do it blind. It's a long ass screamer pipe. And an old school wastegate, but it still works. Alright, so this is where we're at now. Needs this engine mount. And everything is basically back together. I'm sorry I couldn't film at all. A lot of it's dark spaces, like back there, you can't really see that well. And I don't have my tripod, unfortunately. But, get some oil and coolant in it and see if it'll fire up. And if it fires up, then we can drive it. Maybe. I don't know. Who knows? What you hear coming out of the bottom is actually oil, not coolant, so yeah, not that silly. Okay, I'm actually extremely nervous about this. But I'm gonna go ahead and try and start it up for the first time. I got coolant and oil in it, so. Yeah. See what happens. Spitting out something. Wow, the fuel feed line to the regulator is not even connected. Shit. Go runs again. I was actually very nervous to start it up, so glad I got everything correct in there. Sounds good. Yeah, I have to go do some stuff now, like the bar and stuff for Denise, and it's her birthday today. If you guys want to wish her a happy birthday, and maybe I'll be back after. Yeah, and I gotta eat. Fucking hungry. You know, us car guys have to eat sometimes, so like. $2.59 and I get a big cinnamon bun. Eat the shit out of it. Mmm. I'm fat as fuck. You guys have the same issue as me? Like, when you're working on vehicles and stuff, you just forget to eat and you're not hungry, and then when you stop working at like 5 o'clock, you're like, holy shit, I'm hungry. Or you have like a really bad headache because you didn't drink any water? Yeah, that's me. All right, fair warning to anyone who wants to date a horse girl. You have to deal with all horse poops. Whoa, cats. How do you guys get up there? Do you even know how to get down? Doesn't sound like it. Cat likes to be on the quad. Come on, cat. All right, so we're done with the barn, like chores and responsibilities and stuff. Now I'm just gonna go to Napa and I'm gonna grab a bolt because one of the motor mount bolts is actually broken in the Neon, and we're gonna head over and we're gonna get that done for him. Get it back on the ground and hopefully outside of his garage so we can clean it. I've also noticed how hard today it is to do anything without a tripod, so I think I'm gonna have to get one of those little flexible, like 1 foot tripods, and it'll be perfect. I could also use it for like vlogging. It'll be just like a telescopic arm type deal on top of my arm to make a super long arm. But yeah, I can't do anything without a tripod. I'm trying to set the camera up on like logs and toolboxes and stuff. It's just not working. For a place where metric is our units of measurement, they don't stock very many metric bolts. I got this one. I don't know if it's gonna fit, but it was like one of seven bolts. And it didn't even have thread pitch there, so we'll see what happens.
This is our mount. I did it. I did a thing.
Takes a while for it to start. I think the crank sensor or something might be disconnected. And one of those belts is really shit. Alright, I fixed the belt. It was just the alternator belt, so I'm just gonna take it around the block and see what we got. Okay, yeah. Seems like the cam sensor isn't reading, because it takes a really long time to start too, so. We have another cam sensor there, and we'll try and bolt a different one in and see what happens. Probably should have filmed that, but I just used the scan gauge here for the engine light, and these are the codes I get, so. Now I just gotta look them up. I'll be right back. Just like I figured, it was a cam sensor, so I'm gonna swap it out. We have another one here, and I'll be right back. I'll see if that works. Let's give it a go. Didn't seem like it worked. Shit! What do I do now? Oh, still recording. It's gonna seem silly, but there's no magnet inside of it. And I was wondering why the hell I couldn't get a cam sensor reading. But this is the magnet that has to go bolted in there. And then this goes on with two bolts over top of it. Alright, so in theory, this should start up right away if I did it correctly. So you've seen before how it took like 10, 20 seconds to start up. This time it should start up right away. So let's see. It's cold out. It's like 3 degrees or something, maybe. I'm just gonna go around the block. Turbo. The turbo is actually really loud spooling in this car. Uh-oh, we got street hockey kids. Don't hit the kids. Don't hit the kids. Hello? I'm happy about it. Mike's definitely stoked about it. And he's at work right now, actually. So he'll get home probably like 9 o'clock tonight, and it's like 4 right now. So I guess having the car ready for him to drive is gonna be, hopefully he'll take it out tonight. Okay, I can smell burning a little bit, but we did spill a lot of oil, so. Anyways, that's gonna wrap it up for this one. Oh, the camera fell. But on the bright side, it does run. And now that it's back together again, we can clean up the garage, we can do the final touches and stuff on this thing. And I definitely wanted to get this done for him because Mike's like one of the most genuine guys out there, and he'll help anyone if they're in need for anything. So he's always helping out, and it's nice just to help him back out because he's definitely not the most expert guy when it comes to cars, but he loves them just as much as anybody else does. So just like one of the most genuine guys I know. So it's always great to help out people like that because they're always helping you out. So LOL and Leon's back together. It's got a few minor things that we need to touch up again. And yeah, dyno days in 3 days. So that'll be great for my Supra, that is. Make sure if you like the channel, just subscribe, give a like, leave a comment, whatever you want. Yeah, like I said earlier, it's Denise's birthday, so I have to go home now and celebrate that with her. And yeah, so this summer you should see a full-length feature on this car. Hopefully we'll go around hooning some V8s. Yep, that's what a turbo sounds like.
Is this premix?
Good, premix is bullshit.